All right, we're talking about shills on the internet. We're talking specifically about Dabu. Dabu is pointing at Mark Dice, okay? Mark Dice is saying that his channel was terminated, and yet we see, based on other information that we can obtain on the internet, looking at other people who have used the same tactic, that more than likely he is going to get his channel back, okay? Just needs to sell a couple of books, okay? Mark Dice needs to sell his book, and the only way to do that is to create a publicity stunt. And who's helping him with his stunt? None other than Dabu777, okay? Let's go ahead and get back to the reptilian agenda that Dabu is most assuredly involved in, as well as other people. You have Michael Heiser, you have Chris White, you have people like... I'm going to give you an example. Okay, you have Dabu, who is calling out Mark Dice. Will Mark Dice respond to Dabu? No, why would he? It's a game that people play on the internet. Okay, I will give you an example of what Dabu777 and Mark Dice are doing. Michael Heiser has a website entitled Sitchin is Wrong. When Zachariah Sitchin was alive, he had several opportunities to go into a debate publicly with Michael Heiser. Did he ever address or answer any of Michael Heiser's inquiries on his deception or whatever? No. Because that's the game. One person will call out another person, and then that person will just stay quiet, okay? It generates more advertisement for both sides. We as people are very curious people, and so therefore, when we are looking at both sides, we naturally will pick one side. In the case of Zachariah Sitchin and Michael Heiser, since Michael Heiser is claiming Christianity, of course, naturally, the Christian is going to pick the side of Michael Heiser. But like I said before, Michael Heiser is also involved in the reptilian agenda, okay? So before I get to the Jonathan Kleck, let's go ahead and check out... why it is so important to not follow along with anyone, okay? Read your Bible. Stay focused on the Bible. Now, both sides, I'm talking about the reptilian agenda, both sides assume that there are, you know, these evil beings, these evil-looking demons, like Chris White uses the sleep paralysis demon with the red circle crossing it out, okay? This gives the viewer, whether you are a Christian or not, it gives the viewer an impression, okay? And the impression that they are given is an impression that Satan and his angels or demons or aliens or whatever you want to call them are these totally ugly, distorted beings that are going to somehow creep into your window at night and rip your kids off, all right? And that is farthest from the truth. In the Bible, we are told that Satan's angels are beautiful, illuminating beings. Do they have wings on their backs? No, they don't have any wings. They are not ugly, red-faced with horns on their head, like Dabu likes to upload on. They are going to be beautiful angels, okay? So if you're a Christian, be aware, okay? Because if you, in your mind, have been indoctrinated to believe that these beings are somehow supposed to be evil-looking entities, that Dabu and people like him are portraying them out to be, you are going to be deceived. Okay, it's as simple as that. If you're not paying attention to what it says in the Bible, and you are going along instead with people like the Jonathan Kleck or Dabu777, who claims that there is, dragons laying around everywhere, that there is, you know, comets that are going to come and scoop you up and, you know, land on top of your head and kill you or whatever, you are being deceived. Okay, it's as simple as that. And I think I'm going to stop this video upload and we will continue on listening and watching, all right, people who are trying to deceive you.